Babies lack object permanence. When they can't see something, they think it doesn't exist.
Hey, Stewie, peekaboo!
Yes, I see you, fat man.
Where's Daddy?
What? Where did you go? Oh, this is impossible. I can hear you, but I can't see. Really, must really be gone.
Peekaboo!
Ah! How the hell did you do that? Look, I thought you disappeared, otherwise I wouldn't have picked mine. Oh, great, leave when I'm right in the middle of a sentence.
By our first birthday, we realize even if you don't directly observe something, it still exists. Well, most of us do. Even into adulthood, some people think if you don't see a problem, it doesn't exist.
If you don't test, you don't have any cases. If we stopped testing right now, we'd have very few cases, if any.
If we didn't do any testing, we would have very few cases.
If we didn't want to test, or if we didn't test, we wouldn't have cases. But we have cases because we test.
The idea that if we don't measure something, it doesn't exist, is like a lack of object permanence for adults. Trump struggles with testing because he doesn't want to believe there's a problem. To him, testing is a problem. This twisted logic is why he struggles with simple questions like why someone might test positive for COVID.
Katie, she tested very good for a long period of time, and then all of a sudden today she tested positive. So she tested positive out of the blue. This is why the whole concept of tests aren't necessarily great. The tests are perfect, but something can happen between a test where it's good and then something happens and all of a sudden she was tested very recently and tested negative. And then today, I guess, for some reason, she tested positive.
Over the last few weeks, a disturbing development has been the dramatic increase in the number of COVID cases in the US. Trump's tendency to blame the messenger has led to the false argument that the increase in cases is because we're testing more.
Testing is so far advanced, it's so much bigger and better than any other country, that we're going to have more cases.
So when we have a lot of cases, I don't look at that as a bad thing. I look at that as, in a certain respect, as being a good thing, because it means our testing is much better. So I view it as a badge of honor.
Actually, a lot of cases is a bad thing. It's the reason why the U.S. has seen more COVID deaths than any other country in the world. We know more people are getting sick, and not just because we're measuring more. In June, as cases started rising again, we also saw an increase in the percentage of tests that turned out positive, known as the positivity rate. The positivity rate is going up especially fast in states like Florida, where cases are rising the fastest. Increasing positivity tells us the actual number of infections are rising, and we need to do even more testing in those states to track infections. Trump's aversion to testing has practical applications. It means we're not testing at the level needed to detect and slow the pandemic.
When you test, when you do testing to that extent, you're going to find more people, you're going to find more cases. So I said to my people, slow the testing down, please.
There's a new plan at the White House for how to deal with coronavirus testing at the federal level in states across the country. Jeff Bennett reporting that the Trump administration is planning to end its funding and support for coronavirus testing sites at the end of this month. That is on June 30th.
The irony is Trump is in denial about the pandemic because he wants to return the country back to normal. But he's rejecting the very thing we need to reopen safely. We test so we know who needs to be isolated to prevent them from spreading the virus to others. Trying to navigate a pandemic without testing is like trying to walk around blindfolded. Closing our eyes won't get rid of the problem. It'll luckily make the crisis worse, since we won't know how to accurately track and prevent the spread of the virus. Hostility to scientific data doesn't just breed ignorance, it endangers lives and makes it harder to reopen the country. Collecting data and following scientific evidence is the key to solving this crisis, not to mention a general blueprint for tackling society's problems.
Don't forget, we have more cases than anybody in the world. But why? Because we do more testing. When you test, you have a case. When you test, you find something is wrong with people. If we didn't do any testing, we would have very few cases. They don't want to write that. It's common sense.